Okay, yeah, brother Boom, yeah, alright. Look, it's been a long time. It's Double H right here. Yeah. Back again for a review. Look, Ninja Assassin. I think some talk about this, we know. About a year ago, maybe 2 years ago, I was amped up for Ninja Assassin. Like, look, finally, we're gonna get a proper ninja film where we have an Asian as a lead. Which is how it's supposed to be. I'm sorry, but you can't have Michael Dudikoff or some blonde guy trying to be a ninja. It just doesn't work. You know, it's an Asian thing that only Asians know how to do best, which is what was proven in Ninja Assassin, but we'll get to that point later on. The crux of this discussion is about CG. CG has once again, you know, reared its despicable face and ruined this film. McTeague. You see, he is the sole reason. Well, not sole reason, but he is. There are two reasons why this film was pretty much crap. The first reason was McTeague. This guy decided to use CG, too much CG, to ruin the film. Therefore, it looked stupid. I mean, I'll come to that. Right. So, McTeague. The second reason is the script. It was a pretty horrible script. I mean, pretty bad. I mean, it was very basic, beginning, middle, end. But really, as a script screenplay, it was pretty bad. I'm sorry, man. It just not good enough. I'm sorry. Just not good enough. Okay, I mean, the story, okay, we have young guy, obviously, who's played by Rain, brought up as a young guy in this kind of, in this land, and he has, obviously, one of the best guys in this film was basically a guy who used to do ninja films back in the 80s, I think, Japanese guy, and he is basically kind of like the teacher of this school for young guys who to fight, to become ninjas in the future. So obviously some stuff happens, you know, that the master does to Rain's, who's the main guy, to his friend and everything. So then he then now rethinks about this whole he basically rethinks about this whole ninja thing and whether this is the path that he really wants to go on. You know, so blah 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 blah. You can guess what happens. He goes against his master. Now, those ninja guys are now trying to go after him and kill him because he basically betrayed them and all that kind of stuff. He basically turned their back on them. So yeah, you can pretty much imagine what happens. So yeah, that's the basic story. But and also what that's happening, there's this kind of a subplot which intertwines with that main story, which is Naomi Harris, who is a British Jamaican actress who was in Pirates of the Caribbean, I believe, and 28 Days Later. So she's like an investigator working for, I think, some kind of like Interpolish kind of organization who are investigating this kind of ninja corporation who are involved in some illegal deeds and all that kind of stuff. So they had two stories intertwined, Rain's story and the Naomi Harris story, they put intertwined, and then they both had to basically try to fight to take down these ninjas who are coming to kill Rain. So yeah, that's the basic story, but it's like, we all saw that training video on YouTube, you know, we all saw how incredible it was. And I'm going to say again, man, I mean, Rain, this guy, he's a damn pop star. He's a damn South Korean pop star. And first of all, what you saw in that training video, it was shocking. Like, wow, this is a guy who learns all of this stuff. Amazing. And the sick thing is that you see that training video, and you know, I just had it in the back of my mind that it's too good to be true. McTeague thought that, oh, I'm going to be really clever. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make sure that people can't actually see all these good moves that these people train for. I'm going to actually make sure that I film it in a way which is, oh, shows that I'm an auteur and I'm very stylish, where you can't see the fighting. Stuff is is too quick, and the use of CG, especially with the blood, it's just it didn't even feel like if it was violent. Like you can take like an 8-year-old kid to watch and he'll laugh because the blood looks like just some fudge of CG flop or blob or something like that, you know. And just missing that you're making a freaking ninja film, mate. You know, that's what you're doing here. You're making a ninja film, which means that the crux of it is fighting. It's combat. You know, it is a very simple storyline that people can follow, where there's a protagonist, where there's an antagonist, and there's something at stake. You know, but it's like, why? I think, you know what? People think that filming fighting is all you just put a camera there. Yes, comedic. Please, if you just put the camera in one position so you can see everything, then that would be great. But then the other side is that filming combat is an art, which was proven when we saw Batman Begins and Dark Knight. Christopher Nolan just does not know how to film fighting. He just doesn't know how to do it. You know, therefore maybe he should just keep the camera still. The Wachowskis know how to film action. John Woo knows how to film action. And filming action scenes is a skill that some people know how to do and other people don't know how to do it. It is an art form. Like, when you watch the Chateau fight, you can see everything that's happening in the frame. Yeah. The camera is still moving, it's still panning, and every time the camera is moving, you can see everything that is happening within frame. There are guys flying, guys moving swords everywhere, Neo doing this crazy stuff, but whenever the camera is moving, you can see every single thing that's happening. Nothing is blurred, nothing is unclear, and you feel like, here, yeah, I know exactly every kick that comes, every punch that comes, every time that he tumbles, and that's not easy to do. You know, and when you watch the Shashato fight, that is just people who know how to do this stuff and they have a talent for doing this stuff. This is why I just wish that the Wachowskis had actually done this ninja assassin film, because McTeague, he just don't have the ability to film fight scenes. You just can't do it. I'm sorry. You know, and when you watch John Woo and his own action films, you saw like MI2, man. You know, you've seen Hardball, you've seen Hard Target. Like, he knows how to film an action scene, and he knows how to do it better than other people do it. You know, Bay just knows how to blow stuff up. Okay, he doesn't know how to film an action scene. He can do cool shots, but when you're looking at the whole ball of wax, the full construction of it, John Woo is a master at it. But really, when we're talking about combat and complexity of combat, you know, you look at the Smith fight. Look at the dojo fight with Morpheus and Neo. Look at the last fight between Neo and Smith in Matrix 1. It's like, even Matrix Revolutions, you look at that Neo-Smith fight, which has, because these guys, they really are probably the best guys I've seen at filming fight scenes or fight choreography. Complex fight choreography. Look at the Neo-Sarah fight. And there are just some guys who can't do it as well as them, because Wachowskis, you can see that they're being stylish with the way they're filming it, but they also know in their mind that, okay, we've actually got to let people see what exactly is happening. And I think that is what was missing in Ninja Assassins. Like, screenplay was crap. Okay, the story was very simple, blah blah, but there really wasn't anything in it to give us a new light on ninja, the whole ninja mythology. You know, to try and, you know, see, oh, okay, that's actually an interesting take on ninjas. Nothing really of any interest at all for the story. The use of CG was ridiculous. The directing of the fight scenes was just plain bad and horrible. So, all in all, this was a failure. But I still say it's amazing that he had someone like Rain and Amy Harris, two non-white leads, in a ninja film, which is very, very strange. And there's Rain, he did extremely well. Naomi Harris did really well. And I think Rain has a future in film, man. You know, obviously supporting Naomi Harris as well. There is potential to make a better ninja film out there. So peace, McTeague.